북한에다 삐라뿌릴 게 뭐 잘못됐어?
미국 놈 동무.
여기다 시한 아니 이게 이 사람 죽이는 거예요.
Korean War Memorial in the center of Seoul is a graveyard of tanks and planes and munitions from a war that ended in 1953. It was a war that divided this peninsula into two very, very different countries. And while the shooting war has ended, the propaganda war continues.
North Korea is one of the world's most isolated countries, a hermit kingdom hermetically sealed from the rest of civilization. It's a country both astoundingly brutal and almost comically absurd. Its single television channel is dedicated to exalting the leadership of dictator Kim Jong-un and instilling fanatical devotion to his regime. North Koreans are allowed no external internet access, though some can gain access to the country's intranet, also populated entirely with regime propaganda. Getting information into the North was once the remit of the South Korean government, who launched balloons to disseminate propaganda over the border. But the so-called Sunshine Policy, instituted in 1998 to de-escalate tensions between the two countries, saw the balloon launches shelved. That task was then picked up by North Korean defectors. Today, these launches are increasingly controversial and have drawn gunfire from the North and intervention from the nervous South Korean government. It won't be guns and bombs that free the captive citizens of North Korea, activists say. It will be schmaltzy South Korean soap operas. Overdubbed episodes of Friends, and an inflammatory Seth Rogen and James Franco film. Pyongyang declared Sony Pictures' The Interview, a movie which dramatizes the assassination of Kim Jong-un, to be a, quote, reckless U.S. provocative insanity.
I think it says something interesting about North Korea that they decided to have the state mount an all-out assault on a movie studio because of a satirical movie starring Seth Rogen and James Flacco.
When President Obama pinned an embarrassing leak of Sony emails on North Korea, Thor Halvorsen, the frenetic and outspoken head of the New York-based Human Rights Foundation, announced a plan to challenge Kim Jong-un's monopoly on information. Halvorsen is a controversial figure in South Korea, and his controversial idea? To rein the North with copies of The Interview. Along with a small group of Western journalists and Silicon Valley types, the Human Rights Foundation promised us access to a balloon launch. But first, we would be led around Seoul to meet defectors and activists to learn about their sometimes primitive strategies for getting information into North Korea.
동수는 못 먹었습니다만 저 연습을 해봤습니다. 세 사람이 하는 건데 근데 이게 400야드가 넘어가니까 여기서 펑펑 쏴가지고 USB라든지 그런 물자들 넘긴 데는
Kim Hung Kwang's expertise is actually more 21st century. Before defecting to the South, Kim was a computer scientist at Pyongyang, tasked with training the country's first generation of elite hackers.
천재입니다. 걔네들은 충분히 그동안의 실력을 쌓았다면 이번 같은 소니 해킹 같은 거는 뭐 사실상 충분히 하고도 남을 그런 전력을 가지고 있죠.
변인도 대표님 개인 그 영화 보셨나요?
네, 봤어요, 봤어요.
어떻게 생각해서 그 영화에 대해서?
아, 굉장히 그 풍자 영화라고 했는데 우스울 같은데 웃기진 않았어요. 아, 미국 사람들이 이게 북한을 저렇게 잘 모르느냐 그런 생각이 들었어요.
He's been threatened, beaten up, dead rats and blood-covered axe sent to his office. He is probably one of the pioneering defectors in terms of sending information into North Korea via shortwave.
굶어 죽는 환경에서도 북한 사람들은 이래 우스워지게 그렇게 줄여 있어요. 꼭 듣고 싶어요. 미국의 서리 방송을 통해서 아 탈북자들이 한국에 가도 죽이지 않는구나 알았고요.
Once people start getting a taste of these real human stories and real entertainment value, they very quickly get hooked on it, especially the younger generation. DVD players are surprisingly prevalent in North Korea, and crucially, all of the ones going in these days, they don't just have a DVD function, they have a USB input port as well.
You're not involved in the balloon launch stuff at all, are you?
No, I'm not, no.
What's your general sense of these things? Because I know, like, it's funny, because you think, like, oh, you know, pretty straightforward stuff. It's a pretty divisive issue, isn't it?
Massively divisive.
Massively divisive.
Yeah.
What's your take on this?
This is for the record?
This is for the record. You're obviously a skeptic. You've revealed it already, just by these long pauses.
Yeah.
After an exhausting day of meeting defectors brutalized by the North Korean regime, the Human Rights Foundation told us that the balloons would be launched that night.
So we were aroused and brought up to the North Korean border, where we're actually going to launch the balloons at night to try to, you know, keep the press away and to keep all the attention at a minimum, because attention in the past has been a bad thing. And this military truck has the hydrogen in it, all the material that is going to be launched into North Korea.
The launch was organized by defector Park Sang-hak, known as Target Zero in North Korea, its most dangerous enemy. In 2010, a North Korean agent was arrested in Seoul carrying a dozen poison-tipped needles. His target? Park Sang-hak.
I was told by them that the police might come, and if they do come, there will likely be a confrontation. So we're going to unload the stuff now and launch some balloons. It turns out that they forgot the balloons. So we have big bags of money and Seth Rogen DVDs, but we have no way to get them right over there, which is North Korea, which you can't see because they don't have any power or lights.
In his 10 or 15 years of activism, he has never had something like this happen.
I am sure.
We'll just stand out here in the fucking cold on the border of North Korea, because that's totally fine, right?
This is a banner of Kim Jong-un that will be flying with the balloon fluttering in the background and hopefully flying over Pyongyang with a rather insulting message about the dear leader and the poster for the interview.
Tying the bags to the balloons.
Okay. So these are the bags that we're gonna inflate.
Once the balloons are inflated, they'll have a special glue.
It will melt through.
Yeah. That's what releases these bags.
In they're timed.
Yeah. And for that, Mr. Park said it would take about 3 to 5 hours.
There's dollar bills. There's cash in there. There's propaganda, and we also have thumb drives and copies of the interview. So this is the GPS you're putting on?
Yep. So this is a GPS receiver and a satellite transmitter. And so it'll get the GPS position and then send that up to a satellite, which will bounce it back down to a server on the internet. And so we'll then be able to see the position of the balloon as it moves along.
So you put, how many of those are you putting in? Everyone?
No, just one.
If anyone is smoking, please stop smoking immediately. That would be greatly appreciated.
So we have all five balloons filled now. They've done this in a way that they know where they're going to go, and they know they're going north now. They just hope they get to civilization up north.
Henry Song!
Yeah!
Kim Jong-un, Jesus-Bokje, Tada, and Bukhan, Nimin, Hemangaza!
Free the North Korean people!
Free the North Korean people!
Down with the Kim regime!
Down with the Kim regime!
Free the North Korean people!
Free the North Korean people!
Down with Kim Jong-un!
Okay. Okay. Down with Kim Jong-un.
Free North Korea!
Free North Korea!
I swear to God, if I fucking end up in Pyongyang hanging on to this. They look like they've gone. They're sort of circling above. And they seem to be going in the wrong direction right now, by the way. We later discovered that the balloon affixed with the GPS tracker landed not far from the launch site in South Korea. And it wasn't mentioned at the time, but the launch's only connection to the interview was Park's banner. Those overstuffed bags contained no copies of the movie. Under pressure from the South Korean Ministry of Unification, Park Sang-hak was persuaded to leave the film out of this launch. The current political situation, they said, demanded, quote, wisdom and prudence. He reluctantly agreed. But the following day, Park would again threaten his former captors with his most potent weapon, Seth Rogen.
만약 씨 부산가족 상봉도 안 하고 그 시간부터 D인터뷰 DVD와 USB를 대량 살포할 것입니다. 또 우리 정부에서 이상가족 상봉도 제안했습니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have to interrupt right now. There appears to be a confrontation. We believe that someone who wants to protest against us has a right to do that.
The confrontation was between protesters demonstrating against the Human Rights Foundation and Park Sang-hak and some very vocal defectors accusing them of being stooges of the North Korean regime.
Yeah, Kim Jong-un, Choi Young-joo. Yeah, Kim Tae-yang, Kim Bong-joo. 막 귀도 안 마른 게 말이야.
어린 놈이 네가 뭘 알아? 이 신발님 저 아유 저 욕도 하지 마라 이 자식아.
회의에서 돈 받고 나왔냐? 야 김정은이가 돈 줘줬어.
네가 뭘 알아?
이런 소리 아니야.
너 뭐야? 너 뭐야? 뭐야? 뭔데? 뭔데? 왜 잡아? 왜 잡는데?
긴급 체포해.
내려 끌어 내려가래.
긴급 체포해.
때리지 마세요! 때리지 마시라고요!
왜 그래?
뭐야 지금? 어디서 지금 뭐 하는 거야? 뭐 하냐 지금? 이 아저씨 뭐 하는 거야 지금?
Someone came, woman came from behind and grabbed a confrontation. We both got knocked into some pretty prickly bushes.
북한에다 삐라뿌릴 게 뭐 잘못됐어?
The truth of the matter is there are like two people here that are protesting. There are three or four. I think there's some other ones that have been kept back, but it's not a big crowd. They're an angry crowd on both sides. You left a country where there is no freedom of speech. Nobody can speak unless they are praising the dear leader. Do they not also have a right to speak, even if what they say is crazy?
이 사람들 자체가 북한에서 살아봤는지 그러면 이렇게 섣불리 나서지 말았어야죠. 그렇잖아요.
What is the reason that you come out to protest Park Sang-hak?
실제로 남북은 현재 군사적으로 대치 중이고 이런 상황에서 표현의 자유가라는 게 무한정 용인될 수 없는 문제라고 생각합니다. 이런 사람들이 중간에 껴서 북한 인민들의 자유와 평화를 위한다는 미명 아래 자신들의 어떤 이익을 위해 그리고 북한 그 미국 정부로부터 받는 지원금을 위해서 이렇게 사태를 확장시키고 있다. 이렇게.
We were told that the protesters were possibly on Pyongyang's payroll. This suggestion became more believable when, weeks later, one of those protesting the Human Rights Foundation and Park Sang-hak gained global notoriety. Attending a forum on Korean reunification, U.S. Ambassador to South Korea Mark Lippert was attacked by a knife-wielding assailant who slashed his face and wrist. The assailant was Kim Ki-jong, a fixture at anti-U.S. protests, who had made seven visits to North Korea in the past decade. We went to find another failed assassin we heard about, a defector who made an attempt on the life of Kim Il-sung, North Korea's founding father and deity.
He's an assassin, or potential assassin, so I don't want to watch you hard.
Oh, it's open.
Yeah.
We are somehow in a basement parking garage that has a TV studio and people who appear to be making clothes. I don't know what's going on, but I hope we can find out now.
They're literally making clothes.
We're very, very far from the center of Seoul. It took us about an hour to get out here and couldn't find where we were going and ultimately descended into this basement, which is a parking garage. Lim Young-sun escaped North Korea after his assassination plot unraveled. It's important to note that because of the North Korean dictatorship's control of information, it's impossible to verify every element of Lim's story.
그래가지고 91년도에 이제 허위총국 출신 산하들은 김일성, 김정일이가 이제 성묘, 자기 고향에서 성묘를 한다 하는 첩보가 정확하니까 거기서 우리가 자기들의 행동을 하겠다. 그러니까 저격을 하겠다 하고 이제 의견을 나눴고 너무 무서운 마음에 너무 조용해가지고 장소에 와보니까 이게 사교해야 될 사람들은 이제 술 먹고 그냥 자고 있더라. 결국은 우리는 실패하고 정체만 드러난 거지.
For 2 years, the Kim regime hunted Lim and his co-conspirators. Most were eventually caught and executed, but Lim Young-sun evaded capture and slipped across the border with China. Lim owns this underground garment factory, and all his employees are North Korean defectors. In his former life as a military officer in the North, he was frequently charged with shooting South Korean balloons out of the sky.
어떤 거는 이제 그 안에 이제 전단이 가득 달려 있어요. 어떤 거는 사탕도 있고, 어떤 거는 뭐 나이터도 있고, 뭐 담배도 있고, 물품들이 있어요 이렇게. 그러면 나가서 다 군인들 주민들 죽는 거야. 주서 가지고 물건 사탕은 다 먹어버리고, 예, 물건은 다 가지고 전단 재밌는 거, 야한 전단 이런 거는 다 훔쳐놓고 재미없는 것만 다 모아가지고 불태워버리는 거야.
So let me just so I'm clear on this. The South Korean government in the 90s were sending balloons full of porn to Pyongyang. And this is coming down and you're looking at this stuff, which is completely unavailable in North Korea, right?
제일 좋아하는 게 야한 사진이야. 북한에서는 그런 사진을 볼 수가 없었거든. 간부들도 그거 되게 좋아해. 장군들도 좋아해. 그래가지고 야, 보고 좋다. 남조선의 갓난 새끼들이야 예쁘다야 하면서 그러는 거야.
So these balloons and these drops were pretty helpful in spreading information, giving you food and you know dirty pictures, and it was like you know that made you in some way want to go to the south, correct?
그걸 보면은 남한에 대한 그 적대감이 많이 없어져요. 그런데 단 하나 위험한 게 있어요. 김일성이나 김정일을 요구하거나 노동당을 비난하거나 이런 전단이 오면은 그거는 달라지는 거야. 그거는 가지고 있으면은 무조건 꽥 돼지는 거야.
Lim is describing what Park Sang-hak is doing, sending materials over the border that ruthlessly mocked the Kim regime. But Lim is also contributing to the information war by exposing South Koreans to the madness of North Korean television, which most people in the South have never seen.
삐라 뿌리는 거는 애들 장난이고 이것이 엄청난 파워가 있는 겁니다. 그래서 북한에 한 80개의 대사관이 있는데 전 세계에 이 평양 방송은 불법입니다. 우리 국가보안법에. 그런 걸 제가 2006년부터 지금까지 9년 동안 생방송해 주고 있어요.
Because his intention is to expose the absurdity of Pyongyang's propaganda, Lim's efforts are tolerated by the government.
이제 오락이 거의 없어요 북한 드라마는 다 사상 교양.
This is your uniform. Does your hat still fit? Does it still fit? Oh God, you're terrifying right now. I'm scared right now.
미국 놈 동무.
No, don't. Seriously, don't. Can dude, literally, he's playing North Korean television. He's wearing the hat and he's threatening me. This is gonna be an international incident right now. So let's go invade the South. This doesn't look very good because my head's really big.
이게 이 옷이 내가 6-7년 한 10년 전에 우리 유격대로 북한으로 무장 침투하려고 다 구입했다가 한 100명 정도 특수부대 조직해가지고.
You were going to take 100 people, come in through China, and move your way down. Okay. And where were you going to end up? To Pyongyang.
이 지역에서 유격전을 우리가.
It seems like the craziest thing I've ever heard, that 100 guys against an enormous military that conscripts everyone into it and is well-armed would make it from there to Pyongyang.
물론 우리 들어가면 실패할 확률이 높지. 그러나 싸워야 된다. 돌아 지금도 그럴 확률이 높죠. 그런데 우리가 이제 우리 한국 정부가 이제 비열하니까 귀찮고 위험하니까 이 중국 정부가 다 결탁을 해가지고 우리 활동을 다 괴물 지키는 거죠. 그래가지고 계속 피를 흘리는 싸움보다도 이제 그 평화적인 싸움을 계속 하다가 때에 따르면 이제 총도 쏘는 거고 그렇죠.
Another defector using media and modern technology to fight the North Korean regime is Choi Jung-hoon. Choi is the director of Free North Korea Radio, a privately funded station which broadcasts anti-regime news into the North. And he too is ready to pick up a gun if necessary.
내 가족은 이미 그 땅에서 당했고, 그렇기 때문에 이제는 뭔가는 조직이 크고 그 시기가 다가온다면 저는 100% 무기만 들면 들어갈 각오가 돼 있는 사람.
He's also the commander of the very 1970s sounding North Korean People's Liberation Front, an army of defectors, typically clad in sunglasses, camouflage uniforms, and berets, who are ready to flood the North in the event of an uprising. But until the counter-revolution begins, Choi is a soldier in the information war, both smuggling information in and out of North Korea. And this, too, is a dangerous job. Like many activist defectors, Choi is protected by South Korean intelligence agents who sat watch as we spoke and refused to be filmed.
한마디로 우리 슬로건이 뭐냐면 고향으로 가는 길 우리가 연다. 한마디로 그 안에 있는 반체제 세력들하고 연합을 해서 김정은 정권을 무너뜨리겠다. 이게 우리 슬로건입니다. 물론 우리가 그 북한을 무너뜨리려면 이걸 알아야 되기 때문에 북한에 이제 내부 소식통이라는 게 있습니다. 저희들하고 계속 꾸준히 정보를 공유하는 사람들이 있는데 물론 이게 다 위험합니다. 왜냐하면 북한에서는 철저하게 이런 자료들을 국외로 내보낼 때는 간첩으로 취급을 해요. 잡히면 죽는 겁니다. 그런데 공개총살, 가방에다 넣은 몰래카메라, 여기다 시하나 이게 이 사람 죽이는 거예요. 다. 예.
So everybody comes out for the execution? People in the town are they ordered to come and watch the execution?
그걸 공개 총살하는데 누가 재밌어서 보러 갈 사람이 있겠어요? 북한 당국이 누굴 총살하니까 나오라. 강압적으로 데리고 나오는 거지.
Do you know what the supposed crime was that this person committed?
한국 드라마를 봤거나 그리고 전기선을 잘랐거나 전기선 동 전기선을 동을 구입하기 위해서 전기선을 잘랐거나 자 쏜다고 이거 이걸 이거 이거 네
Choi's suggestion that this person was tied to a post and publicly executed for watching a South Korean soap opera is another reminder that, in North Korea, the information war can have deadly consequences.
So we're 45 minutes north of Seoul in Paju at the Odasan Unification Observatory. And right behind me is the heavily fortified border of North Korea. And a few days ago, we were just around the corner launching five balloons full of propaganda material in what we thought at the time was copies of Seth Rogen's movie, The Interview. You know, we fell for that hook. But what we found out when we got here was that, you know, the simple act of sending a balloon full of information or a pretty innocuous bro comedy to North Korea is actually really controversial here.
As we were putting together this film, Park Sang-hak re-emerged, vowing his next launch would include 10,000 copies of The Interview. Previously, Pyongyang said that Park would, quote, pay for his crimes in blood if the film made it across the border. But this time, they promised that an aerial shipment of The Interview into North Korea would be met with not just a few shots of gunfire, but cannons and missiles. Losing the information war, North Korea might take its chances on winning a shooting war.